Okay, this is our spray tender truck. We just put this together this spring. This is a tank 4 is just a water tank. Tank 3 is for 32 or AMS. The only way to fill this tank is out here. I can lock that so nobody can pump water in there by mistake. We have tank 1 and 2. The small tanks are 925 gallons apiece. So they fill out here. We have 1, 2, and 4 can be filled there. Tank 2 here, that is our mixed tank. And we're pulling out of the bottom with a drain sump. The water tank's just use an elbow down into the tank. So when we're filling, water goes in up over the top. Here's our mixing stations. So this is where we use our sticker. Pump it into there. We use Sotera pumps down there. We've got our shuttle cage where we got herbicide and sticker. So we pump sticker into this tank and our herbicide goes into that tank. So we don't mix anything else in that tank. This tank has a jug rinse. All of our other products we put in through there. So both shuttles pump into these here. This is our mixing motor. So we can either recirculate our solution tank 2, or we can pull water from tank 1, tank 4, or our AMS tank, and we have a meter on there. We've got our eductors, eductor for this tank, eductor for that tank. Then we also have eductor tank rinse and a jug rinse. We've got agitation and a tank cleaner nozzle here. We're going to need to move that over here. It's not working quite the way we planned. These are for filling. We got a 3-inch pump that's just strictly for filling the sprayer. So we can fill that 1200 gallons in about 6 minutes. So there's our, this one's our solution tank. So we pre-mix a load up here in our solution tank. We empty that out and then we fill the remainder out of tank 1 or tank 4. We used Schedule 80 PVC where we could. We used hose everywhere else. Tried to stick with banjo flange clamps and stay away from threaded fittings. We made our own clamps with these the stainless bands. So this is the way we mounted the tanks, this tank. And here's our suction side. All the suction is 3-inch. This is fill for that tank. Our 32 tank also has a sump drain that we put in the bottom so we can completely drain it out. So we just made this assembly here. We had to extend our deck out here in order to make room for our shuttles. So we just utilized that for all of our plumbing. We thought originally we were going to do storage, but by the time we got all the plumbing done, there was no room. So the adductors, we just mounted them up here. There's no need to have them under the tanks. So we just made this rail assembly to be able to fasten everything on. We've got overflows that we put through the deck. We used 3-inch on the ones that we fill water with. And then we just built this cage assembly. And then we got the upper part just so that we protect our piping. So when we load stuff with the forklift. Here's how we mounted these cross tanks. That's the front mounting. We still need to go back and paint a bunch of the trailer, but we're kind of in a hurry to get this thing put together this spring. There's our agitators for our mix tank. So we mix a load while I'm spraying. Usually the next load's being mixed up. So when I pull up, there's a load ready to go. So it takes about 6 minutes and we're gone. If I'm doing it by myself, like today, while I'm loading my sprayer, I can actually start loading my chemicals into the adductors. So it's still faster than the old method. We just used an old shuttle cage and put a hinged top on it to throw our jugs in. You can actually throw the jugs through this side hole, which is kind of handy. And we got this set of stairs we built that worked out pretty nice. And they just fold up up out of the way. So they work pretty nice. So far there's really not too much that we really would like to change. Everything's working pretty good. That's for our fill. We just carry a short chunk of hose here. That's probably the biggest pain, is you gotta unhook that hose every time and kind of drain it out, but we pull up close so we don't need a long hose. And we've got some extra storage. We just put a rail up along here to carry some extra jugs. This is a 40-foot trailer. A 48 would have been better with a spread axle. We were trying to keep the trailer from being too long, but weight-wise, we're kind of overloaded if everything's full. Spread axle would help that. And as you can see up there, we don't have any real extra room, so the 48 footer would have helped out. But there it is.